Morning of day two. I have a bleary-eyed but surprisingly well-rested-looking Gabe Walls here. How you doing, Wallsy?
I'm good. I hit the snooze button not once but twice this morning in preparation for day two of this very intense Grand Prix.
That's how champs take it down, guys. It's a double snoozer. That's good.
Yes, it's very important to get well-rested before you have to play the upper echelon of competition in these things. And this Grand Prix has an irregular amount of good players because of the Pro Tour coming up in a week.
That's good. I mean, do you think that's better or worse for me? I mean, I feel like you're going to play more established decks. Like, the metagame is going to be more set. Like, you're going to encounter what you expect more as opposed to, like, random swag.
Yeah, it really helps with if you're well prepared for the tournament, which I wasn't personally, but my teammates were, so ipso facto I am as well. It really helps with sideboarding and knowing how the games are going to play out. And if you're better prepared, even though these guys are great players, it's not really going to matter that much because it's way more deck preparation than the actual playing of the games.
So I watched some of your matches yesterday. You got a little lucky. How was that?
Yeah, I got a little lucky. I like to think that I got in my opponent's heads a little more than that. As Luis liked to put it, one of my opponents instinctively drew his card off of Sphinx of Jarwile when he was looking at it on turn six of extra turns because we had extra turns because we took too long sideboarding around, and I won because he drew the extra card. Otherwise, it was probably going to be a draw. But other than that, you know, it was pretty much just raw talent that got me, that carried me through.
Raw talent and verbal skills, talking them off their game, getting in their head.
Right, getting in their heads really helped yesterday.
I tried to tell you guys, don't let them in. Don't let them in.
They can't. They poked the bear one too many times, and it came out roaring. So, you know, that's kind of how it goes.
Well, hopefully we have more of that to come today, and it'd be great to see a few of you guys in the top eight.
Yeah, I think Jerry Thompson's pretty much a lock if he keeps playing the way he's playing. There are probably two or three people in the room that can beat him. I'm not one of them. And, I would say Luis has an outside shot because he has two losses. But overall, I would say two or three guys are probably a pretty good shot.
Yeah, looking good.
All right. Well, hopefully we'll be talking to you when in the top eight there.
Thanks.
Thanks a lot, Gabe.
Yep.